So good morning. So in yesterday's class we looked at the stability of air parcels and all that. So we have been looking at it in the last few classes, stability of unsaturated air parcels, saturated, then we went little deep and we looked at conditional stability and finally convective stability. The convective stability is a lot more difficult, okay. So you have to first calculate the LCL, and after the LCL you have to, if the sounding crosses this, when it goes to the saturated or moist adiabat, when these cross each other, then it results in what is called LFC, level of free convection. After something has reached the level of free convection, it is unstoppable, it will do some violent mixing and so on, okay. So we are looking at this, evaluating the stability. So I thought, like before, if you have to understand this properly, you have to solve a problem, okay. So please copy down the sounding, please copy down the sounding data from a typical experiment. Maybe somebody said sent a balloon, and then from that instrument all these readings are obtained. This is called a sounding data, okay. There are 7 stations A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and 3 columns, pressure in HPA, then the T temperature, and then the dew point temperature, okay. We don't have time to solve this full problem, but we'll just see how to approach this problem, okay. So the idea is to find out whether each of the layers A, B, B, C, C, D is stable or not, and then if each of these layers is given a sufficient push from below, whether eventually it will become convectively unstable or stable. So it's a long process, it's a long problem. For each layer you have to find the LCL, then you have to find the LFC, and so this can, it is not possible to solve it in a quiz, for example. NSEM is a good idea, give it in the NSEM because it is a test of rigor, okay, and you will have to put lot of points, and you should put a rangoli in your SQT lawn P chart. The problem reads like this. Has everybody copied this down? I will give you 2 minutes, first copy this down, sounding data. The sheets are in circulation. Saujanya is having it. Okay. Choosing the topic. Today you will have to finalize. Problem 42. Plot the following on a SQT lawn P chart. Plot the following on a SQT lawn P chart. A, are the layers AB, BC? Plot the following on a SQT lawn P chart. A, are the layers AB, BC, CD, etc. Are the layers AB, BC, CD, etc. in stable, unstable or neutral equilibrium? That is conditionally stable, right? We call it conditionally stable or neutrally stable. Neutrally stable. Are layers AB, BC, CD, etc. stable, unstable, or neutrally, or in instable, unstable, or neutral equilibrium? B, which layers are convectively unstable? B, which layers are convectively unstable? Okay, just don't start. I am going to give you this QT lawn P chart, but listen to the logic. We will have to first see, Viswajit, is it over? You have to first see which of the layers are saturated. If it is saturated, then gamma less than gamma S, gamma equal to gamma S, gamma later than gamma greater than gamma S, that is the stability condition. If the layer is unsaturated, gamma less than gamma d, gamma greater than gamma d, gamma equal to gamma d. So for the part A of the problem, you have to first figure out whether the partial is saturated or not. From the sounding itself, except this point, the T is always greater than TD. Therefore, the gutbut is taking place only between this. Is it 900 or? Yeah. So it is only between 900 and 850. Okay. That is only in this layer there is trouble. In all the other layers, it is unsaturated. Correct? So you have to find out. So you have to, once you plot, you will have to find out. So this is the gamma. Then you will have to find whether gamma is less than gamma d or gamma d, you know what the value is. What is it? 9.8. Okay, so you have to plot that 9.8, whether gamma greater than, or if you are too much of a stud, then what you do is 100,000 h power minus 970, you find out e to the power of minus z by h, calculate the height, calculate the temperature and calculate the gamma layer by layer. Or you plot and then visually see, is that visually examine. Okay. So the first part is you have to find out which of these layers is saturated or unsaturated. If it is unsaturated, gamma less than gamma d equal to gamma d, gamma greater than gamma d, you can solve this problem. However, coming to this layer seems to be saturated because T is 18.5, TD is 18.5. So this layer CD alone, you will apply the condition gamma equal to gamma s, gamma less than gamma s, gamma greater than gamma s. But now, that is part A of the problem, that's over. Part B of the problem is very difficult. Part B of the problem is each of these layers, when it is pushed, whether eventually it will become convectively unstable or not, that cannot be decided unless you find out the LCL, LFC, this thing and so on. So you find out the LCL, LFC and then find out whether it crosses, correct? Whether the sounding crosses the other gamma S line, that is a very tough way of doing. The other equally painful way of doing is, for each of these levels, attention please, I am telling you something which is profound. For each of these layers, for example, if you take the layer AB, you find out the theta here, and using the relationship between theta and theta E, get the theta E here. You find the theta here, potential temperature, and then theta is equal to theta into e to the power of LV omega S by Cp into T. Using that relation, get the theta E. Then between these two layers, find out whether d theta E by dz is positive or negative or 0. Then take the condition. So what I will do is, I will open out one more column, okay, and then put theta. I will open one more column and then put theta E. And then I will put d theta by dz, whether it is positive, negative or 0. And then last column, I will say convectively stable, convectively not stable, unstable and so on. So this problem will take half an hour to solve. Okay. So in the interest of time, what we will do is, we will first plot T and TD on this QT-LONP chart. We will just take one or two layers and see the normal stability of AB and BC. Okay. And then we will take only AB and see whether AB is convectively stable or not. Once you know how to do it for one layer, then please do it in your hostel, and if you have any problems, you ask me. Then I want to quickly move on. Now classes are limited. We got another 12 classes or so. We have to get on to the other chapters. Is it okay? The first point is, all right. First point, 1030, huh? Okay. Next point, 970 and 25. Next point is 918.5. Next point is 850 and 16.5. Next point is 820. How do you escape? Just click. Okay. Oh, 820, it became again. Inversion, huh? Ah, okay. That's a troublesome point. 820. What? 710.5. -11. Okay, I didn't draw it properly, that's okay, but that is the sounding. Okay. All right. Now, dew point. Okay. What is this F? Sorry, this is F, right? Okay. So other points you can figure out. What is that? I thought I did it. Oh, okay. Where did you put the D? C is all right. What is C? Okay. D is 850 and 20, yeah? 850 and 16. Let's do that. Wait. Ah, now tell me 850 and? That's okay. What is C? 918.5. Okay, so this is okay. Ah, okay. Then? 800 and? Goes like this, yes, sir. Then to 11.5, then I can join this. Rohan, is it okay? All right. Now let us do the different color and do the, what is that? Dew point. Okay, A point is 1000 and 21.5. Then B is 970 and 25, 21. C is 918.5. D is 850 and 16.5. Same, no? 805. -4. -11. 11? -4. Where is -11? Huh? -20, sir. Oh, -20. Here. Correct? Okay. So, somewhere both are touching each other, that is the point where you cannot put gamma less than gamma d, that point requires some special consideration. Okay. So, it is erasing everything. Okay, let us try to solve it on the AB. What is gamma? Approximately. Huh? Or gamma is less than gamma d, what do you want to do? What is gamma d everywhere? If it follows gamma d, what will it be? It follows the, you can't get it from the theta, isn't it? Dry adiabat. No. So what do? You have to convert it into
per h bar.
Per h bar, is it okay? Then what is per h bar for 9.8? How are you going to solve it? Air parcel will follow what? Air parcel will follow the theta, no? Dry adiabat. Why do you want to calculate the gamma? Where is that dry adiabat? Where is the dry adiabat for this? Dry adiabat is this, right? Correct? So gamma is almost equal to gamma d? For AB? Little less. Whatever you say. Less more that height was said, all that is fixed, no? Those problems are not there, right? Other people are also watching, man, they are going to watch this. Whatever you say, gamma is less than gamma d, so it is stable or positively stable, very good. We will just do one more, BC. Gamma equal to neutrally stable, correct? Shall we explore that Gutbud layer? Which is the Gutbud layer? CD, yeah? Okay. Is it CD or DE? CD is the problem?
Inversion is B.
So then we will do CD and. But which is the saturated? CD is the saturated layer, correct. So I will clear this. Okay. Nice. Now, okay. CD, you please tell me. CD is saturated, na? So gamma and gamma S need to be compared. Gamma S is basically the moist adiabat, saturated adiabat. So what is the story now? Anusha, oh, you are not comfortable, huh? You are able to follow? Yeah, yeah, okay. Gamma? Nah. Please tell me. Saturation adiabat is coming on the right, no? This is? No, huh?
Gamma less than gamma.
Gamma?
Less than, sorry. Greater than gamma.
Greater than gamma. Greater than? Okay. I want a few more people to. Fellow is unstable, huh? Yeah, yeah, you are expecting that, right? Gamma greater than? You only told me that gamma less. Okay, AB. I will just say please check, okay, please check it. That gamma D and gamma S are basically the slopes of the saturation adiabat and the this thing. So there is no great discovery, or you do not have to solve a nonlinear PDE. You have to just compare with the slope, okay, at that level. Alright, now let us ditch the DE. You know how to do it now, right? Huh? Shall we proceed? Let us leave this. Now the real trouble starts. So when you solve the problem, it consists of three parts. If it is a 24 mark question, first 6 to 8 marks I will give you for plotting the sounding and the gamma D. Out of 24, let us say 8. Then the next, or 6, the next 8 or 10 is for what you have done now. A, B, C, D, each of these layers 1 mark or 2, 1 mark, let us say. Then coming to the important part is the part B, which layers are convectively unstable. So maybe I will give 6 or 8 marks for the second part, for the parts where you are just looking at gamma less than gamma D and so on. So 12 marks for the other part where you look at the convective stability. So if you have to do the full thing, how long will it take? half an hour. Let's say half an hour, 35 minutes, let's say. So 35 minutes means 100 marks for 180 minutes. So it's a fifth, 20 marks or 22 marks. That's a fair game, right? Is it a fair game or not? Okay, so 22 mark question will be there. So now let's go to, now let please, let's go to, see this problem is slowing us down. Anyway, it's okay. So AB. So you have to find this convective stability, get the theta at A, get the theta at B, get the theta E at A, theta E at B, get dou theta E by dou Z, or dou theta B, dou P, whatever, positive, zero, negative, depending on that. If it is negative, it is unstable, right? This is what we decided in yesterday's class. Now, what will happen? In the atmosphere, a potentially unstable, now as you work on the problem, just hang on. I'll just explain some fundas, then we'll get back to the problem. In an atmosphere, a potentially unstable layer has got the capability to form cumulus clouds. And the cumulus clouds give heavy rain, which is called convective precipitation. If it is not stable, then it is likely to form stratiform clouds, which may or may not rain. If it rains, it will give light rain. So highly unstable layer will lead to that cumulus dark clouds you see evening 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock. Kerala people, you know, every time it's so dark and this thing, you know that ominous signs, okay, that you're going to have a downpour. In Chennai also sometimes in the evening at 5:36 it happens. Okay, that means some cumulus clouds are forming, then there will be a big shower for 1 hour, it will shed its moisture and go away. Okay, so that is very much related to the stability of the air parcel. Okay, now continue this AB. Theta A and theta B can be found from the figure, correct? From this QT ln B. So, you have to get omega s and all that. LV you can take it as 2250 kilojoule per kg. What is the relationship between theta E and theta? Plus, no? Plus. CP is how much? Huh? So get me theta A. Huh? 30, huh? How much? 30, okay. Theta B? 26. Okay, so first get theta e and theta a and theta b from the chart, from the sounding. Okay, then use them in this equation. What happened? It got erased, this one. Okay, now please tell me. How much is theta e a? Omega s and all you can find out, right? How do you find omega s? The dew point is given, na? Marius, how will you find omega s? The chart from the blue line. That blue line you find out the saturation mixing ratio. Yeah. Corresponding to, please tell me. It is lower, is it? Okay, 17, 18, whatever. Theta E B. Other method is to use the LCL, LFC and all that. I think this is easier, no? This is easier, right? Vishwa, what is the matter? So theta e b, Anusha, what's happening? Not getting? Balakumar. Theta e b. So this is the inversion layer, Temperature is increasing with height. That is the inversion layer. Did you get the? You're getting 30.
So if the power is taken positive, then theta is bigger than theta, right?
I thought so. Then let me check. Theta E is theta E plus LV, okay? So this cup, da?
Sir, that is omega, is that point?
It is omega. 18.
Okay, so what? Omega S by CPT. Akhil, the funda is whether theta E has to be greater than theta, or it cannot be from your thing, it is less than. It is some theta into E to the power of some positive quantity which should be greater than 1. So it is already plain wrong. It is not on, it is not correct, isn't it?
Yes.
How can it be? It is E to the power of something, a very small quantity also is more than 1. Therefore, in principle, theta E is always greater than theta. So when you say 30 degrees and this is 18 degrees, it is not correct. So please don't make mistakes. Omega S will be in grams per kilogram multiplied by 10 to the power of minus 3. LV will be in kilojoules. Attention please. LV will be 2250 kilojoule. But omega will be in grams per kilogram into 10 to the power of minus 3. So that 10 to the power of minus 3 and this 10 to the power of plus 3 will get cancelled. Alright. So what is it, Vishwajit? What are you getting? You should get some decent values. Rohan? CP is 1004. If you take 1.00, it is kilojoule. Kirtika. Sorry. 30? Very good. At B? We will complete this. Gone case today, one class, we have just solved the sounding problem.
Be in degree Celsius or Kelvin, sir.
Which one?
Theta.
They have converted finally.
No.
Temperature is this one. Which temperature is this one?
Theta will be in Kelvin, theta in Kelvin, subtract 73 and get it, man. Those things from childhood you are doing. When you are operating, on thetas, you can.
Coming around 100 degrees Celsius, theta E is.
So 73.29. Yes.
Theta N is Kelvin. Huh? How? That is not correct, no?
73.
E value is coming as 1.14 or 1.15.
Yes, sir.
Theta is around 300 Kelvin, then yes.
How much is it?
360.
Okay.
30.
Yeah.
342 around.
If the water is condensed,
is it fine using
to reduce?
Let's not get into that argument now. We'll assuming that the formula is correct, let's finish this. I should have given this as an exercise problem. Yeah, how much is it? 103. Is it correct? I am not sure. Okay, theta E B. 105 are you getting? I am not sure. Then? Theta E B. Yeah, that is all right. The T you have used in Kelvin, right? Here?
Yes.
Kelvin, right?
Theta in Kelvin.
CP is LV is into 10 to the power of 3, omega is into 10 to the power of minus 3, CP is. I thought it will give small values. Omega is how much?
18.
So 2250. Correct. Into what is T?
43.
Huh? How much is this?
It will come 18.
Tell me how much is this? 13. Please tell me how much is this value?
Theta B is
theta A.
Same confusion.
No, no, that's this value.
Approximately 1.24.
Huh?
E power that is 1.14.
What is this value? Just tell me. 0.22. So what is the t to the power of 0.22? Is this correct?
Yeah.
Rohan, just check the values. No.
It's 18. Yeah, omega is.
Somebody told me it's 13.
Omega is 18.
Come on, how can it vary so much?
For A it is 18. For B I will have to.
It should be, it is not 18. It should be 18. Between 20 and 40 it's
30. How do you find omega S?
Sir, omega S should be this.
Omega S is the omega corresponding to the dew point. Omega S is the saturation mixing ratio that comes only from the blue line. This is not LV omega. It is LV omega S.
Sir, omega S will be at point A only, no? At the current point, sir.
Why should you? No.
Are Baba, how will you find omega S at a point unless you know the dew point? What is it after listening to the whole Ramayana? How will you get the omega S? Unless you know the dew point, you can't know the saturation condition. Given a point A, can you find the saturation mixing ratio? It is not possible. That is why the sounding for dew point is also given. Please get your funda straight. The omega at point A is not known. Simple. The omega at point A at any point is not known. The saturation at all these points are known through the dew point. Please understand the sounding, right? So if you take at A, you will get 30, 40, 50 high values of omega. That is not correct. What is the omega corresponding to TD? 18. So that is the correct value. Let us use this. Then the whole thing is? This is 0.113, point, how much is this point, okay, so theta EA is, okay, theta EB, another 3 minutes, we'll finish this, theta EB, get the omega S at B and then substitute and then you have the theta, should be less, correct, no, we don't know. So it is stable, huh? It's stable, right? Yeah, check it. So you're using 26 now, 26 degrees, which is like 299 e to the power of 2250. New omega S will be lower because you have moved left. New omega S will be lower, T is also lower.
68.
Dou theta E by dou Z is?
Negative.
So it is convectively unstable, correct? Very good, correct. Got it. What do you mean by, is there a contradiction? Is there a contradiction between the part A and part B? Part A, I told you that AB, part A was also unstable. Then no problem. Because here the check, no, gamma is greater than gamma D. So, left to itself, left to, attention please, left to itself whether the parcel will be stable or not is decided by gamma greater than gamma D, less than gamma D and all that. This elaborate calculation of theta E is, if the parcel is pushed, whether eventually it will become unstable, it will lead to some cumulus clouds and rain by sustained vertical motion. If you just push it, what will eventually happen to it? That study is a study of convective instability. Is it okay? Now you see you are struggling a lot. So for 8 levels, it will take at least 20 minutes to find out the convective stability. In 5 or 7 minutes, you will find the normal stability. And then another 5 minutes to do the plotting. So 30 to 35 minutes. If you don't make mistakes and if you are fine with the kilojoules and grams per kilogram and all that, you should be able to. Because you are not going to do it 16 times. Don't worry, man. If you are doing AB, for BC, B is already there. For BC, already B is there. For CD, that C will be there. So you don't have to do double calculations for each of this.